My name is Justin Wang. I'm here today to ask for $500,000 for 1% of my company, Larq.
Whoa, still surprising. All right, everybody. So, you know, I started this YouTube channel to show as somebody who was an outsider to the investment world and to the business world. I didn't have anything. I didn't have any resources. I didn't know where to go. Now being an industry insider, I want to start this channel and give you this information because we don't know what we don't know. And so make sure that you go down and you subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this so I can empower you more and give you a lot of information. All right. I always get a question I always get is, how come I was the first investor out on the Larq deal? So just so you know, you're going to see 8 minutes or 11 minutes of it. This is an hour to an hour and a half pitch. So when I'm the first out, I'm not out in 5 minutes. I may be out in 45 minutes, but I heard enough information. All right. So let's go. And I'm going to watch this right now. Watch this video all over again. I'm going to remember a little bit of stuff behind the scenes, but I'm going to share with you my thought process while it was happening.
Next up is a modern version of an important health accessory.
Hey, sharks. My name is Justin Wang. I'm here today to ask for $500,000 for 1% of my company, Larq.
Whoa, still surprising.
Have you ever noticed that funky smell coming from your reusable water bottle? I bet you have.
Oh,
and if you're like most people, you do what we call the sniff test.
Now, by the way, that is a $50 million valuation. It is the most, it's the highest valuation ever, ever in Shark Tank.
Woo-wee. The average reusable water bottle contains more bacteria colony than your dog bowl or toilet seat. No wonder they stink. And it's no wonder it's so tempting to reach for a single-use plastic water bottle. The result? Over 1 million of these guys are consumed every single minute. And that's no good for your health, and even worse for the environment. That's why we invented the Larq bottle. The Larq bottle is the world's first self-cleaning water bottle that purifies water on the go. With a simple press of a button, and in just 60 seconds, the Larq bottle activates our patented UVC LED technology, Purovis, to eradicate 99.99% of the harmful and odor-causing bacteria, viruses, and mold. The result? Pure water from a pristinely clean bottle. So sharks, who's thirsty for a great deal?
Just want to be clear, I heard you properly. 500,000 for 1%.
Oh, Robert, why did he just ask for 500,000 for 0%? He's 1% away from zero.
Reasonable human being. Tell us why it's a
By the way, in all transparency, I have a couple of these.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Great.
You do?
That is awesome.
I do.
But what's the market opportunity that justifies this?
So it's a huge market. Big water is a real thing. It's a $300 billion market worldwide, of which reusable market is only 7%. It is growing. I tried to swear off of single-use plastic water bottle several years ago.
Let me be clear. When I said I had a couple of them, people have given them to me. And just so you know, in the back of my mind is I never use them. Why don't I ever use them? Because when I get home and I have to plug in this ring, my Apple Watch, two of my phones, my iPad, and all the other crap around me, my Bluetooth speakers here, my headless speakers here, my other... What am I going to do? Have a house full of plugs? You got to make life a little bit easier for people. I could see if it was maybe solar, but that's also one of the things I'm thinking. I don't use it.
I bought several reusable options, and sure enough, they ended up in the back of the cabinet or in my gym bag. They would collect mold. If it sat in my car, it would get stinky.
So it's the self-cleaning part.
It's the self-cleaning and purifies.
It looks to me like you have a UV light in the top. Can you explain how this works and what it does?
This is actually an optical system that's designed to reflect the UV light inside. So simply, you press this button, the UV light turns on. My co-founder is a PhD in physics from Caltech. He's engineered this to bounce the optical light throughout the bottle.
So then how many minutes does it take to do that?
We have two modes. Our normal mode is 60 seconds, and then we have a venture mode, which is 3 minutes. So if you want to take it to a developing country or camping, or you're just somewhere where you don't quite trust the water.
Justin, is it safer than boiling water?
It would be the equivalent of boiling your water for like 20 minutes.
Really?
Competition, are you the only one that has UV activation and cleaning?
We launched in October of 2018. We're the first owned one on market. We have about 10 patents, both utility and design.
All right, just something else. By the way, I got to tell you, this company right now is doing about $30 million a year. That means it is a great product, it is a great company, and he's a great founder. However, when he talked on about, when he came on initially about bottles being smelly and stink, I've never experienced a smelly and stank water bottle. And so unless you have a massively nasty amount of gingivitis in your teeth, well, then the water bottle really doesn't matter. You got a bigger issue at hand. However, what do I like? I hate single-use bottles. I hate single-use plastics. It's killing our ocean. So again, you have your give and takes on if it is usable or if it's needed, but if it's going to change the way that we consume our waters and keep hurting our oceans and landfills.
Around this product and other products, but there are copycats out there that we're pursuing potential legal actions for right now.
So Justin, why is it worth $50 million?
So we launched this product in 2018. So we've been on the market for a little
almost
under 2 years.
Almost 2 years, huh?
Under 2 years. And in our first full year in 2019, we did a little over $5.5 million in sales.
There you go.
In the last 12 months, we've done over $9 million. This year, we're planning on doing $14 million.
What are you going to make on the $14 million?
So we brought on our first outside venture capital round earlier this year in January, and we leaned into growing the business. So this year, we're expecting to lose about $1 million.
Justin, how much did you raise?
6.7.
At what valuation?
At a $31.7 million valuation.
All right. Do you understand that he raised it at a valuation of 30 some odd million dollars? Now, there is definitely places that people will change the world to go and raise money, but Shark Tank wasn't created for that purpose. It was created in 08 when people had no place to go to find money because the banks weren't lending it, and they came to the sharks as the last resort of people who were not going to be, you know, loan sharks, right? And we were going to invest in them because they're a hardworking family who spent all their money trying to get something off the ground so they can feed themselves and their families, and we can give them the million, half a million, $200,000. Most people don't understand having a $33 million valuation after 1 or 2 years. And in Silicon Valley and various other places, there are definitely places to go, but I don't feel Shark Tank is the platform to go on, especially when you have money in the bank. Also, if he's caring about cleaning up the environment, well, then if there are copycats out there, well, can you stop the copycats and license your technology to them because you want other people to help clean up the planet? Hopefully he was going to get to that, but I didn't hear him get to that. I'm here to clean up the planet, make a whole lot of money, and I'm not sure if I want other people to clean up the planet. But again, this is early stage in his career, and maybe that's why they're doing well now, because maybe they found other ways to license too.
So Justin, let's talk real business. You've only raised 6.7. How much do you have in the bank?
I have about 6.5.
Okay, so you really...
The man has $6.5 million in the bank. How many of you watching right now has $6.5 million in the bank and still asking for money? Nothing wrong with what he's doing, but I'm just sharing with you my insight on that.
You really haven't had to spend anything,
good for you,
right?
Yeah.
What did these retail for?
The one you have right there is $95.
I paid $95 for this?
Holy
crap.
It's actually not bad.
It cost you what to make it?
The landed cost is around $40.
You said you had a lot of patents.
Yeah.
What are those other products you already have?
Well, some of those patents just cover some other applications, but some of them do apply to the new product. This is the Larq pitcher, which is our first foray into the home. Let me do that real quick. And while that's going, I'll show you a video of how that works. Traditional water pitchers use a filter. And the biggest problem is that they only trap contaminants, where they could quickly accumulate and multiply and actually reverse contaminate your water.
Why do they reverse contaminate?
Because the contaminants are being trapped and collected there. And as germs are growing there, it's a wet, porous environment that's dark. So imagine all the things that could be growing there. So we take a two-step approach. The first step, you see it go through, and it captures things like lead, cadmium, mercury. In the second step, you simply press this button, and it'll purify the water that's gone through. And as you can see, that is a clear water that we pour blue water in that's contaminated.
So it's clear water, but is anybody else doing this?
No one's doing this.
All right, I'm glad I watched this again, because I'm going to buy that.
There's a million people on planet don't have access to clean water, and 1.5 million don't have access to electricity. So I don't think any of those people are getting this bottle right now because they don't have $95.
1% of all our proceeds go to our charity partner, 1% for the planet, Charity Water, WellAware, where we build wells, in Africa.
1% of profits?
1% of revenue we pledge.
Of revenue?
Gross revenue.
Wow. Gross revenue.
Okay.
Pledge.
1%. Okay. That is impressive off top line.
Guys, I tell you, that is super impressive. But again, and I know what he's saying. He's saying, hey, we're going to build wells in Africa and various other things, but the general consumer cannot buy that, and I get that. But 1% of gross sales is extremely impressive.
Top line. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're committed. I get it. That is important. Yep. Daymond was going to stick a skewer through you.
No, I might still, but I want to just lay it out where I am, okay? Yep. I think we're at a time when people are really angry. They're looking for hope. Mm-hmm. And when I signed up to this platform, the platform didn't start off as the wealthy helping the wealthy. With $6.5 million in the bank, I just could not do this because I just think that I'm here for a different reason. I think this is crazy. I'll let the other sharks discuss it, but I'm out.
I also come from a background where I didn't have a lot. It's unfortunate you won't take that journey with me, but I respect what you're saying.
All right, but also let's talk about the money aspect. He's asking $500,000 for 1%. He did say his projected year where he was going to lose $1 million. So you don't get any distribution after that. Let's say that he claims he's selling for 90. He's making the bottles at 40. He's averaging out somewhere about, you know, 50% margin, right? His cost of goods is 40 to 50. He's selling it for 90. His cost of goods is 50%. After he pays for everything from advertising to various other things, he probably will clear, hopefully he can clear 20-25%. If he did $100 million in business, well, 20% of $100 million is he would probably profit $20 million. Now, my 1% of $20 million, you figure it out. How long would it take me to get an investment? He's not doing $100 million. He's doing $30 million right now. He may have already lost $1 million. So just to get my money back, it probably will take me anywhere from 5 to 7 to 10 years. Nothing wrong with that. If you're in real estate, you're into long-term value of stocks, yes. But as of right now, on something priced so high with so much money in his pocket, looks like it's probably not the best deal for me at the moment.
So let me take a shot at it. I support a charity called One Drop, making sure everybody can drink fresh water around the world. It's something I can get behind. Love to be involved in this, but I'm not doing it for 1%. I bring too much value. I've never done a deal for 1%.
I'm going to let my other sharks ramble on, and maybe if you want to look at the rest of the episode, you can. But obviously, I don't want to show everything, because go and check it out, Shark Tank, on all the channels that it's on. I just want to give you my insight. Thank you for watching. Use some of this as you're evaluating whether you are creating a pitch or if you're evaluating somebody who's pitching to you. Remember, it's always the people that you're looking at, more importantly than the product. And in this version, I think the founder is a great person, but I think, however, a little spoiled because of the amount of money that they can raise, and this was not the platform to raise it on. And then I have my other personal reasons why I felt it wasn't necessarily for me. Do I think the product's good? Yes. Do I think that the founder is amazing? Yes. Do I think that this will help change the world and more people need to think like that? Yes. But just because I have money does not mean that I need to invest in every company. Maybe I'll just buy one or two or 10 more bottles. I'm definitely going to buy that one for the refrigerator. But just because you like your favorite restaurant, do you want to invest in it and now have to go in the back and empty the garbage and start scaling fish and cooking chicken? No, you want to go and eat. So just remember that. Just when you run into money or have money, you do not have to buy everything. Truly successful people say more no than they say yes. Wish you all the best. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you subscribe. I got to look over here because I'm looking at the screen. Make sure you subscribe so I can give you more of this information so you can go out and empower yourself and other people. Peace. Thanks for watching. I wish you love and power in your life. Make sure you like. Make sure you subscribe. Check you later.